Hi. Hi, everybody.
Turn it off, please. Turn it off, please. I'm gonna get my other phone.
So this is going to be a long video. I don't think my mom wanted me to go live while she was doing this part. But I feel like this is an important part of a cooking video where you actually see what we're doing. There. Hi, Tiffany. Hi, Sheena. Hi, Eva. So I think it's an important part of the process to see this part of it where you're prepping the vegetables, and she's gonna do it this time. So right now she's taking the pumpkin, and she like had to hack through it because the pumpkin's really hard.
What?
So the pumpkin's hard, so she needed a cleaver to like, because it's a really dense, it's hard. So now she's using the peeler to peel off the skin, and then she's gonna cut that into big chunks. And she's using fried pork.
Apple.
That's tomatoes. So she went and bought some fried pork. And this is what's going to go inside of the pinakbet. And you can save the pumpkin seeds. That's tomatoes. So what goes in this, Mom?
Okra, bittermelon, eggplant.
Long beans
and this one
and pumpkin and tomato, mm-hmm. Onion and garlic.
Stir fry the food, the meat. This can be
so. If there's anybody that's watching that makes this, do you guys use the fried pork or like do you just buy pork like raw pork belly and use that? Because I've never made this before. That's not an apple. Hi.
Where did you put your, did you finish your cookie?
Emily, you took the whole cookie. Now she doesn't have no cookies. God. Share. There. Take that and finish that. Go finish it before she sees you. She didn't take the whole cookie. Oh, Wendy uses both. It's your favorite dish, Weena. Wena, I'm sorry if I said your name wrong. I just cannot remember. Hi, Robin. Chinese roast pork. Okay. Regular raw. Everybody makes it differently. Wendy says she uses both. That sounds like a good, happy medium, yeah. I would think that it cooks faster if you're using the already made pork, yeah? Because even you just have to cook the vegetables. And the pumpkin probably takes the longest to soften. That's a tomato. Hmm. What? She's eating a red velvet. She's eating a red velvet chip cookie from the Molokai Hot Bread people. Hi, Mario. Hi, Candy. We haven't been doing keto for the last couple weeks. I think about what I'm putting in my body. But I haven't been really doing like strong keto-liciousness for a couple weeks now. But I'm going to go back. Hi, Teresa. Hi, Grace. I am going to go back. She's saying hi. You use opai instead of patis. My mom has bagoong and it stinks, Jesse.
That's adobo, you. Alamang.
It's bagoong alamang. And so for those of you that don't know, it's fermented shrimp paste. And if you grew up eating this stuff, it'll smell yummy to you. It attracts flies like as soon as you pop that sucker open. So flies are going to come and hang up on my...
Yeah, but it's cooked, so it's not...
It's cooked, but it's fermented. But that one is cooked with like garlic. There's like flavors in it. It's really good. but it's also a acquired taste. So if you didn't grow up eating bagoong, it might be extra pungent, like when you try and smell it right out of the jar. What? But me, when I smell that, it makes my mouth water, because now I want to get green mango. That's good with green mango. You see what? You see what? A lot of people love bagoong that's on here. Yay! Yay for bagoong!
Louder.
What are you eating? Where's your eyes? Where's your eyes? Show me your eyes. Where's your nose? Where's your nose?
The prepping is the one that took a long time.
Yeah, the prepping does. Hi, J Rose. It does. And like, cooking shows won't show you this part of it. They'll be like, hey, everything's all cut up. Let's put it in a pot. And so it takes longer in real life because you have to prep everything. So that's why I wanted to go live now so you guys can see her like doing it, like peeling and all that stuff. Right, Jet? Mom's going to cut it. What? Because doing the pumpkin part is, I think, the hardest one of all of them, because they're hard. It's hard to cut through. It's hard to peel. What do you want? You want this? I don't think you can eat that. You might choke. I don't know. You want water? Here. What happened to her milk ball snack? I don't know what happened to her milk. Come here, come here, come here, come here. So now we're just waiting for Ramel to come home. I thought I saw UPS. That's strange. Oh. So did you guys see Jay's feed yesterday? When this made Pinakbet on Saturday. Yeah, you gotta have this in your pantry all the time. So Jay did the marathon yesterday. All 26.2 miles. I think she jogged when she could, and then she walked the majority of it. But let me just, she's going to share her experience, like, eventually. I'm hoping that she's still sleeping, because that was insane what she did yesterday. Without any training at all. Like, she didn't train for this. And I actually tried to talk her out of it, because I was like, we don't need you getting hurt doing this. You haven't trained for this. We're talking about 26 miles. But she was like, I have to do it. I gotta do it. I'm like, okay, well, if that's what you want to do, you do that, but I'm going to be waiting at the end. And it's going to be really, really hard. And I've never done a marathon. Doing a marathon is not something that's on my bucket list. Like, it's not something that I feel like I want to do, or, you know, both of us have, like, I don't know why, but after Wednesday, when we were together, we both felt a little under the weather. So we blame Bronson for making us sick. But we both were kind of fighting something. Hold on a minute. And then she didn't get much sleep because her son was, I don't know, teething, I think she said. And then she still did it. And you know what? She did it in under 12 hours. And when you think about that, like, in my mind, I was like, she has been walking on her feet for almost 12 hours straight. That's just crazy. And how do the Kenyans do 26 miles in 2 freaking hours? You know what I mean? 2 hours. How do you do that? Like, how long are their legs? Honestly, she did an Instagram story where they were still like barely cracking the surface of this marathon, and the Kenyans were like on their way to the finish line. That's just insane. I actually Googled Kenyan marathon runners because I'm like, are they just genetics? Like, they're just built that way? And when you, I was kind of reading up on it, and this is what they do, like, on their daily. Like, they're this, we drive everywhere, they run everywhere. That's what they do growing up. They run miles to go to school from when they're little. So they're just built and put in that environment where running is just a daily life thing. So running just, they don't do it, it's not even for fun. They just do it because necessity, out of necessity, they have to run, you know. But it's just freaking amazing that they can run 26 miles in 2 hours. That's just freaking crazy. And it said on the average runner usually finishes between the 4 and 6 hour. But I'm like, man, just thinking about running for 4 hours, I can barely run a mile without dying. That's just crazy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was probably that crazy lady from my Paulo High School.
Remember, when I was in kindergarten, we used to walk 1 mile?
Yeah, we do 1 mile. We can walk 3 miles, but I don't know about 26. Like, I've done the Great Aloha Run twice, and I don't want to do it again. I don't know what the prize money was. Hi, Roxy. What was the route? If I remember correctly, I believe they started someplace in Ala Moana, and then they actually went around downtown and then came up. I don't know. You can look it up on HonoluluMarathon.com. They have their route up there. But it was just freaking crazy. And the thing is, when you're looking at the route on a flat, like, app or on a computer screen, it's flat. It doesn't show you terrain that it's hilly. And there's, like, some hills on the way back. So when we were driving to look for her towards the ending part, oh, my God, we were driving through, like, Kaimuki side, like, Kahala Avenue, all down there, and it was just hills. And I'm like, oh, my God, they're already dying, exhausted, and they have to walk up this freaking hill. And so you can look up the map on Honolulu Marathon, and it'll show you the route that they had to take. But it was just crazy. I'm like, oh, my God. And so while we were driving around, so me and my girlfriend, Danelle, she came with me to go look for Jay. While we were driving around, we went and stopped at Kahala Mall, like the McDonald's, so we could use the bathroom. Hi, Sally. And so we kind of took a break there. We used the bathroom, and we kind of just talked a little bit. But on the way to McDonald's from where we were, where we found her on Kahala Avenue, we saw so many. So Jay wasn't the last, obviously. The last lady was on the news. But there was a lot of people that was behind Jay that were walking. Some of them looked, they were all in there. They were all senior citizens. Some of them had canes. Like, some of them were literally, like, walking, like, bent over and, like, and they kept going. And I'm like, my God, like, to keep pushing through all of that is just amazing to me. Age, condition. There were people in wheelchairs that did this marathon yesterday. There was somebody that did it on stilts. And I was talking to Jay a little bit this morning. Emily, I'm talking right now. Please don't be rude. And Mama's holding a knife and she's chopping something really hard. No, I don't want any injuries. But so there was people in wheelchairs, stilts. Jay said there was an older guy that did the marathon with a tuba. So there was all kinds. And then there were also a lot of people that, like, fell out. Like, they just fell out and quit. And I'm like, my God. Right, Wendis? That's why I told her, you can't walk now. You can't walk for a whole week. Like, her blisters are bad. And so one of the things that I did before I went over there was I went to Walmart and I bought some, like, I don't care if it's in the house slippers or whatever, but I was looking for stuff that looked like clouds. It needed to be soft and fluffy and not hard at all, because her feet were going to be very tender, because I wanted her to get her feet out of those shoes as soon as she crossed over. So I brought her that. I brought her some Aleve so she could pop those as soon as she was done, because she's going to need that. And I also brought her some deep blue rub for her muscles so that she could put that on that night, and hopefully it'll help with the aches and stuff the next day. And I even brought her turkey sticks. Mommy, I know it's so weird. But I was like, she's gonna be, she might be hungry and she might want to eat something, but nothing heavy. I don't know. I don't think I would want to. And so I just found turkey sticks and I brought those with her so she could have that. But I was like thinking more of what she probably, what would I want when I, after I did a 26 mile thing like that. Like, I wouldn't want to lay. I wouldn't, you know, I'm not saying that it's bad, but I would be like, water, water, food, and I need to get these shoes off. That's what I was, like, that's what I would be wanting if I was doing something like that. So my mom is chopping up all the pumpkin.
Wait, that's,
I don't know what kind of tomatoes these are. Cherry tomatoes?
Pumpkin?
Cherry tomatoes. Sleep, right, Christina? So, you know what? The first time I did, the Great Aloha Run, the first time I did it, did I do it with Ramel? I'm trying to think. No, I think the first time I did it with a girlfriend, and she was a little overweight, and so I did it to support her. I, you know, and I still to this day can't find her. All I know is she moved to Wisconsin, and I can't find her anymore. But I did it with her. That one was fun because we were both, like, taking it in stride, like, we'll jog where we can, and then we would walk, and we would do the 8 miles together. The second time I did it was with Ramel and a couple of his army friends, and they were all active duty at the time, and so they were runners, and I was trying so hard to keep up with them, and I couldn't, and so they were done, like, they were done in, like, a couple hours, and I was just, like, dying, and so now I'm, like, left in the back, you know, like, kind of, like, by myself, just trying to keep myself going. That by the time I got to the end, my mental state, I was just mad at the world. Like, by the time I was done, I was just pissed off. I didn't want to eat. Can you help her with the iPad? I didn't want to eat nothing. I just wanted to take off my clothes and go lie down. But after we were done, Ramel and his friends wanted to go get breakfast. They wanted to go zippies, get pancakes, and I was just like,
you don't like me.
I don't want to eat. You guys are making me wait. I gotta wait at Zippy's. I gotta wait for the food. I just wanna go home. It was just, I was not. So, yay, we're making Pinakbet. So, I can't even imagine, like, what it was like, what it would be like after an 8 hour thingy. Apple, that's a tomato. It's a tomato. Can you give me the pink rag over there, please? So I can clean up this water. Can I have the pink thing, please? Thank you so much. What? Here. Take that. Go have fun with it. Go play with her. Go roll it on the ground. Where's the pink ball? Go play with the pink ball. Can I turn on the pan now, Mom?
No, wait. Let me slice.
Huh?
Gotta slice the onion first.
Oh, she has to slice the onion first.
And the garlic.
And the garlic. Are you done with the peeler?
Yeah.
Where is it? Ta-da! No more lost peelers. Many a peeler I have lost. So now she's doing the onion, the garlic, then we're going to turn on the pan and start cooking. We were just talking, sorry, Jay, before you popped on, about yesterday. Oh, I'm good. You know what? I for some reason today, I just felt very sluggish. So I dropped Emily off. I fed the baby, fed myself, and I went back to bed. And I just stayed in bed with the baby and enjoyed being in the bed with the baby all day until it was lunchtime. And then time to pick up Emily. And so now I'm up because I have to do my Tupperware gig now tonight. I just didn't want to catch a cold because we got caught in the rain. You were probably caught in the rain 100 times yesterday. What do you want? Eat that lime. Eat that lime. Just bite it. Bite the lime. Naked and I wasn't naked, but, and you know what? I didn't even do Netflix. I had the TV off the whole day. Can you believe that? So the baby was playing her grammar games and phonics games on the iPad, and I just relaxed next to her. And it felt good. By the way, Jay, Ramel cut the grass and trimmed the bushes yesterday. You need to do more marathons. Just kidding. I didn't even realize that he cut the grass until I went and looked outside like late this afternoon because it started raining, and I was like, oh my god, all the grass is trimmed, the yard is clean.
Yay, give him a star.
Yay, give Brahma a cookie.
Give him a wall. Well, I give him Oreo, that's why.
What?
I give him a one bag Oreo.
Oh, he said he had that from a long time ago.
No, I give it to him when I was here.
Oh my god, he's such a liar. Ooh, it's chocolate.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Mom.
It's a chocolate cream.
Where's your chopper? No need. Never mind your chopper.
Oh my god. It's cooking good.
Okay, there's no such thing as chopper. Your kitchen is shaking all over the place.
Mm-hmm. Mm. This is a really good cookie.
I need them.
Do you put patis in Pinakbet?
Yeah, but I don't like the patis, it smells. The bagoong, because it's cooked, so there's no smell on it.
Mom, bagoong stinks.
If you don't cook it. But mine is adobo bagoong.
Okay, bye, Jabe. Even if it's cooked or not cooked, bagoong stink.
Okay, whatever then.
But patis is stink too.
I know more patis.
I have, over there. In the bottom.
Patis.
I don't know. Is there anybody watching? Do you put patis in yours? This really stinks. It has to stink, right? Hi, Cindy. Can I turn on the heat now?
Yeah.
To what? Medium. Medium. Five. I'm going to put them on 5.5. Hi, Doria. There's Yvette. Yvette, you've been missing me on lives because you were saying you don't get the notifications, y'all. Yeah? Okay, so onion, garlic, ginger, and eggplant, okra, long beans, pumpkin, kabocha pumpkin is what she's using, tomatoes. I'm going to put this all in the description probably later tonight or tomorrow, because after I'm done with this live, I have to get ready for a Tupperware meeting. What is opai? Isn't it like baby shrimp? Hi, Jen. You have junk kind nose and stomach. It's starting to rain again. So I'm heating up the pan to 5.5, which is like a medium high.
Is it the big size?
What?
The meat there? Do I need to chop them?
And for those of you guys that are, this is the fried pork that we're going to be putting in there. I think you have to cut it.
Wait, where's the pumpkin? How do you put it together? I'm just going to cut it like.
The baby is on the iPad playing her game. Emily, you know you have your own tablet, yeah? Can you please give her that and get on yours, please? Give her that and go on your tablet. Thank you so much. You need to go on yours and do your Raz Kids because your teacher can see your login and she can tell that you're not doing your Raz Kids.
Is it hot?
Warm. Okay, I'm going to turn it up a little. 6.5. So we don't have to... Are you putting this first?
Oh, I'm going to use the onion on the pan because this is already...
Because that has grease already.
I clean my hands, okay?
Oh, she already washed her hands in case somebody is like, Emily, she's touching it. La, la, la. Wow, 2 feet of snow, Paula. You guys don't do like virtual rallies, like online kind? Hi, Carlos, Nancy. Every time I see Garza, I think of Imua Garza, the singer guy. Stop it, Emily, right now. Oh, tiny shrimp. That's what it is. Jed loves Pinakbet. Me too. But I don't know how to make them. Emily is mad because I told her to get off the iPad. So, because she, so her fundraiser, she sold 170 something items. So she went, got up to the level where she didn't hit the iPad level. Instead, we took the cash prize and I used the money to buy her tablet. So she has a Kindle. No, level H. I got the letter from the teacher already. That's your tablet that you won.
My level is J now.
Okay, fine.
You don't know my level now.
Is it hot enough?
Yeah, Mom. Did I put oil?
Yeah, a little bit. Just.
Can you guys see the pan? Yes. A little bit oil. This is a 5-quart pan. I don't want to put too much oil because the pork has a lot of fat. Okay, now what? I'm going to lower the heat down to 5. Are we doing the onion and garlic first?
Garlic.
Yes, these scissors are. And you know what? I don't know if they're going to keep the scissors in the catalog starting January. But they brought the scissors in for this current catalog. And I don't know if they're going to keep it because this is the... I want to say this is the second time I've seen it come out in the catalog and then they make it go away and then we can't get it no more. I actually keep a pair of those scissors in my glove compartment in my car. I don't like the bittermelon too, but it's good for you.
Okay.
So what am I putting in first?
Put the garlic.
And the ginger.
Garlic first and the ginger after.
So there's, this is ginger.
Just for the taste too.
It's not that much, just very, very little ginger. Can you guys see that? And then this was probably 6-7 cloves of garlic. Use as much as you want. And a medium onion. I have the heat on medium because I don't want to burn it. You can see the pan. I'm gonna move the camera so you guys can see inside the pan. Wait. Can you guys see inside more? There. That's the ginger. So I have it on medium. It's on 5. 38 in New York. Oof. Here, Mom. I don't want to put the heat up too high because I don't want to burn this stuff. When we put the vegetables in, I'll turn the heat up a little more because it's going to be full. This pot's going to be full. Carabasa with pork and long beans. Somebody is requesting. Jed.
Oh, my God. Jeff.
Jed.
Oh.
There's Jed and there's Jeff. I think Jeff went off already. Jeff is busy filming. Did you guys see Jeff did a review on the new movie with Sharon and Richard Gomez? For those of you that watch Filipino movies, I want to watch that movie so bad. Oh, now she's adding the tomatoes. These are cherry tomatoes. Okay. Okay. This, by the way, this base right here, onion, tomato, garlic, ginger, is a base for a lot of Filipino dishes. And let me just say, you can start with this and put corned beef in it, and it's awesome. You can even do this and add Portuguese sausage to this, and that's really good. And then you add eggs. Oh, my God. So now she's adding the fried pork. I'm going to turn the heat up to about 7 because the pot's going to start getting fuller and fuller. But I want all the flavors to, like, marry each other. I have watched A Star Is Born. Oh, my gosh. It does smell really Ono right now, Sharon. Sharon, are you, I saw your name and I saw your picture. Are you the Sharon from 808 Body Works? I mean, I know you're not called that anymore, but I saw your, like, I'm so sorry for not really remembering, but I saw and I was like, I swear, that's where I used to go get my massages before. And you guys used to have massage schools and stuff. Hi, Winnie. My booty. Oh, it is you. Hello, Sharon. Where are you guys located now? Are you guys still in Waipahu? Like, I used to go there for, like, regular massages. And then I went for, like, a prenatal one, too. But I don't think you guys are called 808 Body Works anymore. Okay, pepper. How much pepper?
That's good. Just for the taste. And then, you need the patis. You want the patis or the bagoong?
I want put both. Here come the flies. There you go. So this is what the bagoong looks like. Up close and personal. Be thankful that you can't smell it. Oh, you don't do that anymore. Oh. Well, good for you. Good to see that you guys are doing well. So she's adding, I don't know, like 2 teaspoons of...
No, just one for now.
Well, a heaping. It's a heaping teaspoon of alamang. How do you say it? Alamang? Pinakbet? That's how you say it, man? It's not pinakbet. It's pinakbet. It's like that... Oh my God, the smell. Oh, see, this is how come I never, like, take a shower before I went rally. Because if I took a shower already, I would go to rally smelling like freaking pinakbet. I would go smelling like bagoong. Hi, Amy from Florida. Oh, look, it's RJ. RJ, you're not working today. Mama's making pinakbet. Hi, Sherry. Now she's adding patis, so now it's double whammy on her nostrils. What?
The vegetable.
So, how many eggplant is this? This looks like saute. Oh, it's bittermelon. She bought the really big kind bittermelon.
So, it's not bitter.
It's always bitter. It doesn't matter. This is a Filipino dish, yes. So, she's just going to dump all of it in there. How much eggplant and...
Whatever vegetable, how much,
You want of each one. Use whatever one you want.
I know you only like vegetables, so
I like mostly this. Mostly I like the kabocha pumpkin.
You just put them on top.
So now you're going to put this on top.
Cover it.
Cover. You put a cover. And let it cook itself.
For now.
Wait, let's close the bagoong, shall we?
We really need it.
It's like an invitation for Fly City over here. Just kidding. The strainer, it is. This is my grandma's lumpia strainer right here. So many people have commented and said you guys have... Oh, wrong camera. So many of you have commented and said you guys have the same strainer. I don't, you know, there's no markings on here. I don't know what company makes this, but if you guys figure that out, please let me know because I'd like to get another one. I know it's not Tupperware, but there's just the star strainer. This is what we called it. And we're hanging on a final leg. The second leg finally popped off recently. The first leg fell off probably when I was 10. And then we still have one leg left, but yeah. I need another one like that. This is a lot. I don't know. Mom, how can you cook so much? Like,
I have to take some home, so I don't need cook.
Oh.
The next time I go make arroz balenciana, not easy.
Oh, balenciana. How much water I gonna put?
I already put.
Oh, how much water did you put?
Half of this.
So about 8 ounces of water?
No.
That's like a 16-ounce cup.
One and a half cup.
And so now we just let it cook.
Simmer it.
You let it simmer. Simmer forever. I think Ramel's on his way home. Mom, how are we opening it? Should we sprinkle salt?
Yeah. You have patis, that's why I don't put salt. Ooh, that looks good.
So don't add salt?
You gotta taste it first because you put patis.
I mean, just for the vegetable. Like, look, like 1/8 of a teaspoon.
in this salty water.
No, it's not. 1/8 of a teaspoon.
This is, it's hard to flip it because it's not a thing.
Just leave the cover on. It's gonna soften and then you mix at the end. Oh, okay. See? Not nagan.
I need to taste the sabaw, that's why. Ooh, look, look there. Where's your spoon?
Look, look, look. Look at the sabaw in the bottom. See the sabaw? Like that. Screenshot life. And... You like my sound effects?
It's good. It's crazy. Sure, I can cover it.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, just cover it and leave it. And we're done. Ta-da! So this is why I wanted to use this particular pot. The cover is glass. So you don't have to keep opening it to see the condition of your food inside. I'm going to turn this up to 8. Because this is a 5-quart pot pan. And it's full to the brim. So with the tempered glass cover, we don't have to keep opening it and releasing out all the heat. We can see the condition of the vegetables and know when it's ready to like just stop cooking it. So once everything gets all soft, it's probably going to take, I'd say, 10 to 15 minutes, maybe even 20, because the pumpkin is really, really, I keep looking here and it's, you guys are here. The pumpkin is really hard, and that's the one that probably takes the longest to get soft. So it's probably going to have to simmer like this for 15 to 20 minutes, and then it'll be done, and you eat this with rice. If you want to. So right now I'm trying to earn the 6-quart Dutch oven pot that Tupperware has. It's just like this, that's the way it looks on the outside with a glass cover. But it's a taller stock pot, which is good for these kind of dishes. So the reason I don't have it is because I can't afford to buy them. I have to earn them all. So I'm trying to earn that. How do you stop? Excuse me. How do you spell sabaw?
It's A-B-A-W.
Oh, you got it right, Sharon. You can just not... Or you can leave out the okra, Kalena. If you wanted to, you can leave out the okra. I like okra in Pinakbet, so...
Let me do this.
You can... I think you can spell it with a O or a W. Congratulations. Say good job, Romel, for cutting the grass. And he cut the grass. I only waited 2 months because he broke his hand on them.
So that's how meat is doing now.
Yeah. Can you guys see inside the pot? There's pork belly in here, Yvette.
Oh, they can see the whole thing now, not only the vegetables.
They can. Right there, they can see. Look, like that. Oh. So what mom put in... Oh, hi, Cole! What mom put inside was patis, bagoong, the pink alamang one, and water, and salt.
Yeah?
That's your favorite part.
Because the small one is bitter.
Yeah, that's the so there. There's different bitter melons. They have the small kind, then they have the, I call that the small Filipino kind, and then there's the big howley kind, the ones you find in the grocery store, the big one. The bigger ones are less bitter than the small Ilocano ones. Oh, they all said good job on cutting the grass. Can you show them your outfit of the day? OOTD.
Cowboys.
Wait, they can't see. Oh, excuse you. Look, how come you get extra deodorant on? Where you came from? You want some face? No. Let's go meet your girlfriend after work.
Yep.
Punch your face. Like, you know when your husband comes home and he smells extra fresh? How come?
Because I don't sweat anymore. I stay in an AC office now.
Like, for real though, like, don't you expect them to smell a little bit sweaty, like you was actually working? He smells like he just came out of the shower.
How does sweat in front of women?
Daniel said, about time you cut the grass. Oh, Jed said, yes, cowboys.
good. Carabasa.
Daniel watching.
Right there, Danny. Aren't you in Vegas or something, Daniel? Oh my god, the dinner smells so unolish. Okay, so I have time to eat and wash this bagoong out of my hair. I don't like the Tupperware meeting smelling like bagoong. Mm. Oh, hi, Joey.
And Jamie.
Hi, Michelle. Oh, Erica says, the Bears.
What?
Go where? Bears. Right there, right there.
Oh, yeah.
Go Bears.
Okay,
them
go.
Too. They're all right.
The sabaw.
They're all right.
Romeo, I'll try the sabaw. Go get one small spoon.
I can't mix it with Oreo.
Oh, well, shoot.
I told you.
I told you. Here, just cover it now. And we're going to turn on. Is this.
So give them the.
Wait, is this thing soft?
Yeah.
It's soft. She wants you to take a screenshot.
Yeah.
No. What's happening? What you doing?
I was going to flip it.
Oh, my God.
Put it back.
Oh, my God. Mom, she has the tomatoes. Can you get. She's going to squish them. Romeo, get the tomatoes.
She
go put inside the bag, baby.
Thank you.
Put inside mama's bag.
Rosie said, go Patriots.
Okay, turn it off right there. Remember the
okay, turning off heat, so it's cooked a lot faster than I expected.
Why do chicks always like the Patriots?
I don't, because of that guy. I don't know. I don't, the guy that chose the ball. What's his name?
Daddy.
Crazy. I don't know.
What? No.
Okay, let's cover it now.
Put my
taste the sabaw before you cover, so then you don't have to keep opening.
Say hi.
There you go.
Hi. What's up, Robin?
Okay, let me try. Niners. Tiffany said Niners. So we turned
Niners,
off the heat.
Right. Niners.
We turned off the heat and
KC.
We're just gonna put the cover on.
Yeah, I'll give them credit.
It's good.
Mahomes,
just leave the cover on,
pretty
and then we'll just let it continue to cook with the remaining heat, and we're done.
Hi,
oh,
Grace,
we have to do a screenshot. Okay, ready, guys?
Is that what it is? Pinakbet.
It's Pinakbet. Okay, ready and wait. Let's do this. Go like this, and that way you have the handle. And
Montel.
There we go.
From Texas.
Screenshot life. Thank you, everybody. You guys are always so good at doing the screenshots for me. Okay. Ta-da! So we're gonna cover this. The heat is already off, and then the residual heat from the stove will continue cooking, and it'll get nice and soft. And then we can
Niners won, Raiders won. It's amazing.
What?
Redskins
oh,
lost.
Candy?
That's all that matters.
I'm gonna reheat the rice.
give her some of this.
I know the soup with the rice.
They got smashed by the Giants, and the Giants suck this year.
Okay. What can I help you?
Go give that rice so I can feed
okay.
My cookie.
Okay, we're going to log off. Time to feed the baby because she
bye
smells the
guys.
Food is ready.
Thanks for
bye.
Watching.
We'll see you guys later. Mama's supposed to make some more food, she said. She said it on camera. Bye, everybody.
Bye.